Good morning. I'm Kyle.
And I'm Allie. Today is Monday, March 17th, 2014.
It's the 128th day of school.
The weather will be a high 51 and a low 44 with partly rainy skies.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and the singing of the Star Spangled Banner.
Next, we'll pause for the moment of silence reflection. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Let's call interviewer McKenzie and our special guest, Mr. Seymour.
Good morning, Mr. Seymour. Welcome to GVES.
Good morning. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm awesome. Thank you for asking. Happy Monday, everyone. Happy St. Patrick's Day, everybody. I actually made that happen. Yay. All right, happy St. Patrick's Day. I know everybody took the chance to coordinate their outfits to wear some sort of green. And since we be in Green Valley, that's just adding to our great Gator Day. So we're going to begin our day with our lunch menu. Do you have that for us on our meatless St. Patty Monday?
Our lunch today is pizza, lentil
loaf.
Or yogurt, fruit salad, whole wheat dinner roll, cauliflower, sweet potato, apples, or mandarin.
Okay, so as you're making your selections, please be sure to choose wisely, because what you choose this morning will be what you receive this afternoon. Want to make sure that you enjoy your lunch hour, make sure that you enjoy your meal, but also conversation. So please monitor your tone of voice while you're in the lunchroom, and want to make sure that you don't have to empty your trays as a group. You can go individually. That cuts down on the traffic on either side of the lunchroom. We have a wondrous word for the day. Our wondrous word is
coordinate.
Would you hold that up for me, please? Awesome. Coordinate. The wondrous word comes to us courtesy of Anna and Andrea, fourth graders in Ms. Berg's class. They found the word coordinate in a book entitled Baby Mouse Monster Mash. Baby Mouse Monster Mash. Any of you ever heard of that title before? So this is a new one? Okay, pretty cool. Anna and Andrea found the word in the following sentence. We need to coordinate our costumes for Halloween, baby mouse. We need to coordinate our costumes for Halloween, baby mouse. I'm thinking. Since the title of the book is Baby Mouse Monster Mash, I'm wondering if their costumes have anything to do with a certain holiday, since it says Monster Mash. Is that indeed a party? Are they getting ready to get their costumes together for a party? And to whom is speaking to Baby Mouse? Is this a sibling, a cousin, a friend? All questions I'll have to ask when I see Anna and Andrea. From the way the word is used in the sentence, Anna and Andrea believe that coordinate means make something look better. To make something look better. What do you think coordinate means?
Kind of like cooperate with it.
Coordinate, cooperate. Cooperate means to, okay. I see you're thinking. Good guessing there. Good prognostication, I guess. All right. And at the bottom, they write, thank you for choosing my wondrous word. So thank you for submitting your wondrous word, Andrea and Andrea. Thank you very much. The definition for coordinate is?
A set that is designed to match.
Awesome. So whomever is speaking to Baby Mouse, they're wanting their costumes to match for this Halloween Monster Mash. So they're trying to make sure that they coordinate. Just like we are going to endeavor to coordinate our efforts of being safe, respectful, responsible, and resourceful, not only today on this meatless St. Patty's Day, but also each and every day, everywhere we go. And with that, I bid you a happy Monday. That's all I have, Gators.
Thanks for visiting us on GVTV. Now back to our anchors, Kyle and Allie.
Have a great Gator Day. Bye. SDR.
Come as they will, it's Patrick Murphy's.